Good evening, friends. I hope you are all doing well. I'm also fine. I was COVID-19 positive for last 2 weeks, but now I am feeling well. So now I'm trying to shoot a new video. So today I'm going to show you how you can create a new AWS EC2 instance and set up PHP, Nginx, and a free SSL certificate using Let's Encrypt. And I will also point a domain to that EC2 instance so that you know how to link your domain to your web server or EC2 instance. So let's get started. I'm in the dashboard of my EC2 console. I'm now going to create a new instance here. And I will choose Amazon Linux 2. So that's the one. Then I will stay within the free tier, so T2 Micro. Then I will keep everything as it is. I will choose an IAM role. Now, this is the IAM role that I have created previously. Let me show you what's inside this. So if I go to IAM section and then roles, and inside the roles, I will click the EC2 role for SSM. This is an EC2 role for SSM, which has permissions to SSM full access and S3 full access. That's it. Why? Because using SSM, I'm going to connect to that instance because I don't need to use PuTTY or terminal anymore using AWS Systems Manager, SSM, I can now connect to that instance from the console. So that's the one that I need to choose here. Then enable termination protection. I will take this on because I don't want to accidentally delete this instance because it will be a production environment. So the last part here in the advanced details user data, I will put a startup script. The script is available in my website. I will also give the link of this script in the video description. So check out the link. This is from my website, awswithadik.com. Set up SSL with PHP and Nginx. So what I will do is I will copy this part and I will paste it. This process means that you don't need to run those commands manually. This will run from the system automatically when it is launched. So this is a startup script. So that saves time. You need to run all those 8 or 10 instructions one by one by one by one. And that really takes time and that's annoying. You can automate this. But what this does, it first updates the yum package, then it installs the Nginx 1.2, enables the PHP 8, installs PHP 8, starts Nginx, enable Nginx, start PHP FPM, enable PHP FPM, and then install Let's Encrypt startboard for Nginx. So it's simple. You just copy it from the website and then paste it here. Okay. Next, I go to add storage. That's fine, 8 gigs. Add tags, I'm going to add a tag. Project. Back advisor.com. So next I'm going to choose a security group, which I have already created. That is this one. Simple, I just opened port 80 and 443. So that's the two ports that I need. I don't need any other ports because I'm going to using Systems Manager to connect to that instance. Review and launch. Okay, that's clear. Port 22 is not open. Okay, I already have a PM file created previously, but if you haven't, then you can just create a new one. So let's go to launch instance. Okay. View instances. Okay. Meanwhile, this instance is launching. I'm going to create an Elastic IP. So I go to Elastic IP section, allocate an Elastic IP, allocate. Elastic IP means it's a fixed IP. What happens in AWS that if you stop an instance, then IP is released. And you, when you restart again, you get a new IP, which is not really suitable because I want to have a fixed IP for my domain to work fine. So that's why I need a fixed Elastic IP. My Elastic IP is allocated. And if I click to the details, this is my Elastic IP. And if I click associate Elastic IP, that means I'm going to link this Elastic IP with an EC2 instance. And here in the dropdown, I will see my instance, which is running. And I can now associate the IP with this instance. That's pretty simple, but that's really, really a helpful tip for newcomers, because if you don't have an Elastic IP, each time you reboot your instance, you will get a new IP. Each time you shut down and then turn it on again, you will see that you will get a new IP. And if you pointed your domain A record to this instance, then you need to change every time those A records, which is not really good. So ideally, I suggest everyone to have an Elastic IP so that your A record is not changed every time when you reboot the system. Okay. So it is still initializing. This takes some time because they are running a lot of scripts, installing a lot of things, and this is good for that. Okay, then while it is being prepared, what I need to do is copy the Elastic IP. This is the Elastic IP. I click here and it's copied, and I'm going to point my domain to that IP address. So this is my domain, backpackadvisor.com. I will put the IP. At this moment, no proxy, that's fine. And then no proxy. That is also fine. So I set those IP addresses. Now, this will take time, but that's fine because my instance is also not ready. Okay, it is still initializing. Now, while it is initializing, I go to my website and go to the next step. The next step is to create an Nginx server block. What is a server block? Server block is used for virtual hosting. That means I want to point a domain to a particular folder on my server, and this is the definition file where it says which directory contains the file or which directory contains my website addresses. So this is an example given here. If you wanted to learn more, there is a brief article written, you can see here, which is almost a long description with a video how to do this. And this is an really prepared one, which you can just copy and use it. Let's copy it, open in a notepad. Okay, this is an example server block. What I need to change is the domain names. So I copy the domain name, that's backpackadvisor.com, and I change the domain name to this one. Similar here, and also okay. So all other this here, I think this is also I need to backpack change to var www backpack. That's fine. All other things you can keep it as it is. Okay, so sorry, this needs to be changed. Okay. And that's okay. So there's my server block. That's really ready. I'm going to copy this and create a new virtual host. So let's go to connect to that instance. So what I'm going to do is let's make this screen bigger. Then I'm going to go to CD, so sudo vi etc nginx conf.d, and then backpackadvisor.conf. I go to edit mode and then I copy the whole server block. I paste it here. Then I need to reboot the system, which is by running this command sudo systemctl restart nginx. So I will reboot the nginx only, not server. That's typing mistake. I will reboot the nginx only to take effect that your virtual host. Okay. Now, as I have pointed the domain, so let's try to go. Okay, that's fine. It says 404 not found because I haven't created the server block. Then cd dot and sudo backpack. Now, let's go to backpack. Let's try to create a index.php file. And then I'm going to write it here with PHP info. Now let's try to refresh this. Okay, so this shows that this is the PHP 8, 8.8, 0.8, and all those settings are given here. Now, what I'm going to do is this is not still not secure. I'm going to install SSL. And the process is simple. I have already installed a certbot from my startup script. If you can see, this is the commands to install the certbot. Everything is written here. Now, this is Python 2 certbot nginx. If you're using Apache, then just change this block to Apache. That should be fine. So I'm going to copy this sudo certbot nginx and paste it here. Mytools.com. Yes. Okay. It will ask me for the domains where I want to enable the SSL or HTTPS. So there is two domains, or actually one domain and one subdomain. This is the main domain and this is the subdomain with www. So I want to have both. What I will do is 1, 2. Or I can leave empty. That's also fine. So it will now verify the domain automatically using certbot. It will create an SSL certificate and it will make a redirect from HTTP to HTTPS. Okay, now let's refresh this page and you should probably see that this has been already SSL and the certificate is issued 8 August 21 till 06 November 2021. So that being said, this is a very simple and easy way to set up an SSL certificate in Amazon Linux 2 using Let's Encrypt. I have used Nginx, but if you want to use Apache, that's also fine. You just need to change just one more thing here. Remove from Nginx to Apache, and that should be fine. Okay. So that being said, this is the shortest tutorial, and I hope this helps you to set up SSL in your EC2 instance. Thank you, and have a nice day. Bye bye.